this Vac-Con DE12 Pro combo truck is a lot different than other trucks out in the market. To be exact, there's a lot more than five things, but there's five major things on the Vac-Con side that makes this truck completely different than any other combo truck out in the field. And let's see if you can figure out which five things make it so different. Well, first and foremost, it's a dual engine 12 yard. So we've got a pony motor on the back deck that runs the water system. What's unique about this dual engine truck is this has auxiliary engine hydraulics. So not only is it really nice and quiet up front, but with auxiliary engine hydraulics, we can actually pull up to jet a storm line or a sewer line and turn this chassis off. Just run all the water and hydraulics off that pony motor. So it's nice and quiet up front. We can have a really nice, easy conversation with operators instead of it being a single engine design screaming at you off the front of the truck. It also has the pro reel. So this pro reel articulates 180 degrees, but also slides across the front bumper. So you have 69.6 square feet of working area out front. It also comes with a sewer guidance system. So you have a camera on the front of the reel. This camera shows you that 69.6 square feet out front. So you know when you pull up to that job and that manhole or catch basin's anywhere within that highlighted area, you can pull that parking brake and step out. Safety is a huge factor with this reel. You're not having anybody hop out and give you that wave saying come forward and move back to get in that position. We want you guys to be out of traffic. The other nice thing is I don't ever have to put my back to traffic when I'm operating this truck. I can always face towards traffic flow and be as observant as possible. We know drivers aren't paying as much attention as they used to back in the day. Everybody's staring at their phones. This truck can be used to block traffic. We want to put the truck in a place that makes sense and operate the truck in a place that makes sense. So we can pull up to that job, turn those wheels of that truck, and make sure that if anything were to happen in the rear, we're never gonna get hit at the front of the truck. So I can always maneuver my control panel around to a spot where my back is not the traffic flow. So it's a dual engine truck. This also has a fan vacuum system. So it's a dual engine 12 yard fan. This fan will vacuum underwater and pull a straight water column. Okay, it will completely vacuum underwater. There's limitations to a fan, just like there's limitations to a PD blower, but there's not as big of a difference vacuuming underwater as you'd think. So with the chassis, we've got a Freightliner 114 SD Plus, Cummins L9 370 horsepower, Allison 3000 RDS automatic transmission. With that plus model Freightliner, you get a ton of upgrades. If you're interested in an interior tour, I've got other videos out there that show you a full interior tour of this Freightliner 114 SD Plus. One big thing that makes this truck different is water storage. I've got 1,300 gallons of water on board. You can go up to 1,500. With this 1,300 gallons, you got four tanks beneath the frame. These actually have 80% of your water below the frame of the truck. Those tanks up top are just that 20%. So keeping that low center of gravity, again, safety is a big factor. We want the driver to be comfortable and the operator to be comfortable. Talk about comfortability. We also give you a full deck on the truck. So anybody in fleet, any mechanics that are working on the truck, they're able to hop up on a nice stable deck. We're just not putting floating attachments onto a chassis rail. You got a full deck to work on this truck. We're putting remote grease on it. You can grease things, that way you don't have to climb in or climb up to grease them. We want to limit that as much as possible. Harder it is to grease it, the less likely it gets done correctly. Four places we send water: front jet hose, low pressure handgun at 750 PSI, high pressure or hydro excavation system gets the full pressure of the water pump, and a debris tank flush out in the back of the tank gets full pressure of the water pump. A unique thing about Vac-Con and about this truck, we customize your water system. So this has a 50 gallons per minute at 3000 PSI, which gives you the rotter hose at 3/4 inch instead of just automatically going to 1 inch. It's a much easier hose to maneuver. It goes back onto the reel a lot easier. And guys that are cleaning 8 to 12 inch pipe that are mainly doing sanitary stuff don't need 80 gallons per minute. You're wasting water. You could always go 80 gallons per minute with a variable flow valve, but if you're never getting into big pipe, just push 50 gallons per minute. You can taper that down with your variable flow valve and spend more time over top of the manhole. When we roll this way, you see the Lazy Susan pipe rack. You also got a J-hook rack there with your 8 to 6 inch digging tube. makes things really easier when you're hydrovacking. It's non-conductive. It also goes from 8-inch down to 6-inch, so you eliminate all those clogs happening with those nice shaped rocks that get lodged into the elbow when you're hydrovacking. You got a level indicator up top. That level indicator is an external system for automatic overfill protection. We don't depend on anything inside this tank to create a seal. There's a float ball tied to that arrow. That arrow comes up when the debris goes up, and then it hits a limit switch on the side of the tank, doing completely external automatic overfill protection. You also got a vacuum breaker door on your wireless remote or the control panel to give you immediate on-off for vacuum. So that's gonna seal that vacuum off, give the operator the ability to let that rock fall off that boom, and then press the vacuum breaker button, go right to full vacuum again. Instead of turning down your vacuum or turning off your vacuum, it's automatic relief. This flat style door here has a big splash shield, makes dumping really easy. You got a nice overhang off the back of the chassis, so you're not dumping all over your rear bumper assembly. And this splash shield makes it a little bit less of a mess every time you dump. So this door actually has a receiver, oval shaped receivers for the hydraulic cylinders. So when this door opens, we can crack it open a little bit, or we can open it completely and let the floodgates go. We'll roll around this way. This is where our air is exiting the debris tank. So that air comes out, flows through this air routing, and then enters a cyclonic separator. This cyclonic separator spins that air down to the bottom and shoots it right up through the top again, allowing that fine particulate or that dust to settle out in the cyclone. One hand is all you need. You pop open this door with one hand. You don't need a whole big clamp or anything like that. I'll even close it up with one hand. Nice and easy to get in. That way it's nice and easy to clean out when you dump. We don't want you to have to go through a lot of clamps and a lot of T-handles to unlock a bunch of stuff. This pony motor is a GM 6-liter gas engine. We do diesel pony motors or gas pony motors, but the gas has become really popular. Got a 55-gallon gas tank in between the frame rails. You fill up your gas here. Think about this, auxiliary engine hydraulics. I turn this chassis off when I'm jetting lines. All I'm burning is gasoline. So I can run jet lines. Anytime I want to vacuum, I can start that chassis up and go to vacuum right away. One big thing about this truck that makes it different too, you don't need to choose if you're going into road mode or jet mode or combo mode in the cab. If I want to run this truck, I pull up, pull the parking brake, I can engage my transfer case from the front of that pro reel or inside the cab. I never have to choose in the cab. So you always have the variability of knowing you can control this truck from the front and you can drive the truck inside without any worries, not to get confusing with operation. If you have any questions, shoot me a comment or send me a message. As always, work safe and buy Vac-Con.